Hi there, I am Meredith McCoy, the voice of Android 18. How sad to work so hard for so little. I'm also the voice of launch, and you're listening to the Bois podcast.
Did you enjoy the ride?
Hey, Dad! Get the ball! Get it, Dad!
There you go, Marin, you little firefly. Hey, girl.
Wow, she's adorable, Krillin. How would you like to see your dad compete in a martial arts tournament?
First, she'd want to know if there's any prize money involved.
Oh, hi. Nice to see you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to our episode of the Bois podcast. My guest today is a voice actress, and singer. You may have heard her voices Launch, Android 18, and Marin in the Dragon Ball Z franchise, Fuchi Go Mine in Lupin the Third, Maria Ross in Full Metal Alchemist, and many more. Her song, Empty, was featured in the film The Imposter. And she's also the founder and singer of Song Lab. So welcome, Miss Meredith McCoy. Welcome, Meredith.
Why, thank you very much. I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. So, Meredith, what have you been up to? How are you doing?
I am doing so good. I've been super busy, which is not a bad thing. We just got back from LA, where they did a premiere of the new superhero movie. And I just released an album, so that's been super exciting and busy as well. So I'm like saying super a lot. So we're just, you know, because it's fitting for the new movie coming out on Friday. Are you going to go see it?
Yes.
Well, awesome. I'm going to bring my sons because they're really excited about it as well. So
that's cool. Yeah, because I don't know if I told you too, I don't know if you noticed, I interviewed, they say like he's the main villain of the movie, Damian Clark.
So. Oh, yes. Me and Damien go way back.
So, what made you want to become a voice actress and singer? Who is your biggest inspiration for voice acting and singing?
Yeah, you know what? It's funny because I hadn't really thought about voice acting. It wasn't something that I necessarily like was super pursuing to do, but I was definitely pursuing acting and singing. And so funny enough, Dr. Giroux, the guy who plays Dr. Giroux I was working with him on a theater show, and he said, "Hey, Mayor, they're looking for a couple girl characters. You should go and audition for this." And I was like, "All right." So his name's Kent Williams, by the way, he's awesome. And so Kent was like, "Go try out this audition." So me and Laura Bailey went in and auditioned for Android 18. And I had no idea what I was even walking into and that I'd still be doing it 22 years later. So it was quite the adventure for sure. But I have been acting and singing for a really long time. And have always pursued that. But yeah, the voice acting was a total surprise.
Oh, any people you idolize your work after? Or?
And not so much. I mean, I always loved Disney growing up. I could imitate all the Disney characters and the girl singers and all that kind of stuff. So I've always appreciated some good voice acting and good voice work. I wouldn't say there's like a certain person that I've like really modeled after as much as I'm just a people watcher. My stepdad was a disc jockey, a DJ for morning shows. And so just voice work in general was always fascinating to me. So.
Wow, that is really cool. And that you're like your voice acting and music, you're so talented.
Oh, thank you so much. I have so much fun with it. I love it.
Awesome. Now, what is your favorite voice acting role you've done and your favorite song that you've sing in general?
Favorite voice. I mean, it's hard to beat Android 18 just because she's so cool. You know, she's such a fun character to play. But I will say one of my all-time favorites is Launch. We just laugh a lot with Launch, you know, with her blue hair and how she's like, "Oh, it's so dusty in here and I just washed my hair." And then she immediately turns into, "Hey, you," you know, so she just has such a variety and, you know, she's hilarious when she gets mad and blonde. So, you know, That one might be one of my favorites as well. Song-wise, I tell everybody, I'm like, whatever song I'm working on is usually my favorite, you know, because it means a lot to me in that moment. So I can't say that I have one official song that's my favorite. It's like, whatever I'm working on at the moment is usually the one that I love the most.
Now, if you don't mind, if I could ask you, like, some characters, we could do some of their voices, if it's possible.
Absolutely. Like,
okay. Android 18.
All right. The voice of Android 18 sounds like, how sad to work so hard for so little.
That's so cool. And then if you could, Marin Launch and, you know, Yusuke's mom and you actress. Sorry.
Oh, my goodness. Let's see. Okay, I'll give you Launch.
Ooh, it's so dusty in here and I just washed my hair.
And then she goes, hey, you! Ah, I'll get you for this time. Oh, I'll do one with that too. Hold on. I'll go,
That's you!
Hey, you!
That's so cool.
Atsuko, she just sounds kind of like me. I haven't played her in so long. So I feel like she's just kind of my voice. I don't even have a line for her. And then let's see, Marin. Goodness gracious, I only played Marin for a couple times. From what I remember of Marin, it was probably just, Mommy, Mommy, where are you, Mommy?
That worked. Thank you so much. Thank you for doing all those voices. That's so cool. Like, you could change your different tones, pitches. Like, it's so cool.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Now, can you walk me through the audition process? How did you get the roles of Android 18, Launch, Marin? Like, how did you get those roles?
I kind of told you how I got Android 18 with this through, you know, just going in with Kent Williams and bringing me in. And then, you know, it just became like this small little family. Chris Sabat and Sonny and Justin Cook was the engineer at the time. And Chris Sabat was the director. And so we all just kind of became friends. And funny enough, with Launch, I modeled her after one of my roommates in college. She was from Philly and she just had this, like, she was this beautiful blonde, but man, she had an attitude and she had an accent too, kind of that Brooklyn accent. So I was like, definitely modeling her after her, and they thought it was hilarious. And so we ended up just using it. And we still, to this day, anytime I've done some, she's kind of come back with some video games recently and we've just died laughing. They were like, this character needs to come back more often.
That's so wow. So your roommate, when she would sneeze, I'm kidding.
Yeah, she turned into a hot-tempered blonde with a machine gun. No, but she was a hot-tempered blonde for sure. So just modeled her after her.
that's really cool. And then Justin Cook, which is really cool too, would be your son in Yu Yu Hakusho too, which is really crazy.
Isn't it crazy? I know. And I just got to see him recently and it's so fun to catch up with everybody. I mean, I feel like it's funny because I feel like we really did grow up together. Damian Clark, all those guys, we would travel early on. Like I said, I told Krillin, I mean, I've been personally married to my husband, Michael, for 17 years. And I said, I've been married to Krillin and Android 18 and been married longer than my husband and I, which is pretty crazy. So I've known Sonny Strait longer than I've known my husband.
Wow, that's awesome. It's almost like a big happy family. If that makes sense.
It totally is. We really have like known each other and just, you know, we used to, I was telling Sonny Strait, we used to, when we had to travel some for Comic Cons and whatnot, we'd like, going down the street, singing together. Like we have all these funny memories. So it's really fun.
Wow. That's awesome. Now, favorite DBZ character besides, you know, the ones you voice, who are your favorites?
Who is my favorite DBZ character? You know, I might go with Vegeta. I don't, you know, just because it's really fun to fight him too. You know, he's just kind of that grumpy guy, but then super strong and just, he's just got a fun attitude. So maybe him.
Wow. I'm shocked. You say your brother, Android 17.
I mean, he's pretty cool too, I will say. And Chuck is an awesome guy. So, you know, he's fun. Krillin, I can always say Krillin. He's hilarious, you know.
Now, before I ask you my next question, remember that surprise I told you, remember you're wondering why there's an Android 17 pop? It's a cool surprise. Okay.
Let's see.
Okay, I got, okay, let me see if it'll load. Sorry about that. I'm sorry, Meredith.
Oh, no, you're good.
Loading. Okay. Loading. Okay, I also gotta turn down my brightness because it might be too bright to see. Can you see it?
Do you know
that is? Okay. Let's see. Let me turn it up for you to hear. Okay, ready?
Uh-huh, I'm ready.
Hey, Joe. Hey, Meredith. You know, funny thing, Meredith and I have been sisters, android brother and sister for a really long time, but actually, I don't think I met you until, like, or at least I hadn't seen you since, like, the Battle of Gods premiere. Like, we'd only seen each other twice in our entire lives. True. I think we saw each other again at a convention somewhere. I don't know. But people think, you know, your brother and sister, you probably, like, play tennis together. And I'm like, no. My butt in tennis anyway. Okay, so I'm supposed to have a question for you. What was your favorite thing about any convention that you've ever been to? What's the best one you've ever been to? Also, name your best fan interaction. Okay, I'll talk to you guys later.
You mean the dragon pose?
That's right.
That's awesome!
Yeah.
Oh man. Well, then I will say my best Comic-Con or like con that we've been to. It's not Comic-Con. The best con actually was the last one I went to, which was Kamehameha-Con, and I actually got to see Chuck. It was one of the second times that we actually got to meet. We got to do this epic picture together, which was super fun. My favorite fan interaction. Well, this one's kind of silly, but I think it's hilarious because it was a long, long time ago when we first started doing autographs. And I remember some little kid, I mean, he was really young, probably 5, asked me to sign an autograph. And so I just signed an autograph and he came up to me so upset. And he was like, I can't even read this. He's like, you signed something and I can't even read it. And I mean, it was just my signature. So I guess it was cursive. So it wasn't in print. So, you know, when you're only 5, you don't read cursive usually. So I felt like I was such a disappointment. I'm like, sorry, buddy. And so I think I wrote something else for him, but I just thought it was funny that I was a big disappointment for signing my signature.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. Like, did you enjoy that little surprise?
That was a great surprise. That was a super awesome surprise. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
It's true. And tell him, you know, it's funny because I really, you would think that we've gotten to hang out a lot. Krillin and I actually have hung out a lot, but for some reason, Chuck and I have just never been in the same place at the same time.
Wow. The siblings. Wow. That's nuts.
I know.
Wow. So I'll tell him you enjoyed the question because I keep in touch with him. He's one of my good buddies, Chuck Huber. Got you.
Awesome. Yeah,
thank
he's a good guy.
Now, you're signing some. What would you say then? Like another question. What was the weirdest thing you've ever had to sign? Like the weirdest? Anything weird in particular come up?
It was usually in the early days when, before like people, you know, it's a different culture now. People pay for autographs. But beforehand, early days, they would just give us a big stack of stuff and people would just bring their own stuff and they'd be like, sign my arm. So I think I signed a few people's like arms and just random things like that. I think that's probably one of the most random ones. I did tell people though, I'm like, I don't sign nude pictures. I had some that are like, and I'm like, oh, that's on the edge. I don't know if I'm signing that one, but yeah, I don't sign those.
Now, you know, over the years of your career, do you still keep in touch with co-stars and directors you've worked with? Do you still keep in touch with people?
A little bit, yeah. I mean, like I said, I just got to see some of them recently, you know, at this last premiere. And then I'll see them sometimes at cons or different places. But Stephanie Nadalny, her and I used to sing in a band together years ago. She had me, she actually had sang in a band. She was like, they're looking for a girl singer. So I sang with her for a year or so. And so, I mean, I feel like I've had a lot of different interactions. Damien and I were in the same acting agency for a long time. So we would see each other on other jobs and other acting auditions. And so, yeah, I feel like we've kept up. Laura Bailey was in my wedding, you know, so every once in a while we'll, you know, interact back and forth. Not super often. It's been a little while, but yeah, I feel like, you know, we're all friends because we've known each other for so long. So.
Oh, is there a role you would love to do in a movie or TV show that you would love to do that you haven't done, like a Western time travel? Like, is there a certain type of role you would love to do?
Oh, I just would like to play a Disney princess for sure.
Ooh.
I just like to be a princess. I just want to sing Disney style. I think it'd just be really fun. Then I could just bust into song at any time. So definitely something that I can bust into song and be over the top happy.
I could see that, though. I could see you being a type of character.
It's yeah. funny because that's the opposite of what I play at Dragon Ball Z. All my characters are super tough and mean. So maybe I just play a fun, over the top happy character.
Now, who would you say is the coolest person you have worked with? Who deserves the coolest person?
Coolest person award, like in general?
Yes.
Or like as in like voice acting?
Ooh, you could do both. You could do both. You want to help you
get coolest person I know. I really think my husband is cool. I know that sounds silly, and we've been married a long time, and I still think he's really cool. So that's pretty cool. I like to hang out with him. He's fun. And then I'd say, you know, I gotta say Chris Sabat's pretty cool. He just is. He just, you know, he's super eclectic. He likes. He's got such a cool house, likes design, just always had these interesting things he likes. He's just a fun guy, so he's always fun.
Wow. And he was also another new Hacker Show person.
Yeah, totally. Well, it was like a small world. It's funny because all of us played on all these different characters early days. It was just like this, like I said, a little family that played all these different roles and characters.
Now, if you didn't go into voice acting or music, what do you think you would have done as a career, or what other interesting hobbies do you besides music and acting? Music and voice acting.
Ooh, other than music and voice acting, who knows? I love babies. I'd probably end up like a midwife or something crazy like that, helping people have babies. I don't know. Because I've always just loved all the creative arts. So it's hard for me to say that I would not, that I would want to be something else, because I love music. I love writing songs. I love all things, you know, creative. And so to like go into something totally different, I'm like, what would that be? Maybe that.
I could see like an acting teacher. That's who you remind me of, like an acting
teacher. An acting teacher? Yeah. See, that's it, but that's still kind of the same thing, which I like. Mm-hmm. For sure.
Now, favorite band or artist and type of music? What kind of music do you like?
What kind of music do I like? I mean, I love good pop songs. I mean, most everything that I write and what I do is going to be worship music, because that's my like genre. So I love that and I listen to it a lot and I write that style. But man, I love pop as well. A good pop song that's got a good beat. I like to write pop songs too, just because those are fun. But I appreciate all kinds of music. I also used to sing in a jazz band, like jazz and big band and all that kind of stuff. So I love singing that style. That's really, really fun too. And then I used to swing dance and teach how to do like swing dancing and ballroom dancing and salsa dancing and all that stuff. So that was fun.
Wow. Any like musicians you like? Like any people that stay out to you? Any people?
Musicians and people. Musician wise, I mean, there's okay, goodness gracious. Let me think. I mean, I usually think more like songwriter style. I mean, song, that's hard for me to say. I don't know. I don't know if I have a good answer for you. I like so many. I'm like, I love Bruno Mars's voice if you're going to go like pop. And then old school, like Justin Timberlake and all those kinds of people. But then, if I were talking about worship, I love Stephanie Gretzinger. I love I have a ton of, there's a girl named, now I'm going to blank on her name. But Hillsong has an incredible girl who's just a fantastic singer. Taya is her name. And so, you know, I have a lot of favorites for different reasons.
Now, some of your favorite movies and TV shows, what are some of your favorites?
You're going to think I'm hilarious, but I don't watch much TV or movies. I mean, I'm telling you, the first movie that I've seen in a long time is the Dragon Ball Super superhero movie. It's been a long time. My kids are like, Merit, Mom, why don't you watch a movie with us? I'm like, I'm too busy. I'm busy creating. But classic movies, Princess Bride. I love it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is that the one with the Carrie Ells? Is that the same movie I'm thinking
of? No, I don't think so. Maybe. Princess Bride is, I can't even remember.
Oh, it's been so long since you've seen
it. It's been so long since I've seen anything. I know. I'm no fun. Everybody's like, how are you an actor and not watch movies? I'm like, but I watch people. Does that count?
That counts. Now, what is your favorite food? What's Meredith's favorite food?
Ooh, I love anything. I love Mexican food, really good Mexican food, because I live down in Texas, and so it's that Tex-Mex, anything good, chips, dips, guacamoles, any really good salsas, I'm down for. Really good sushi, I'm down for. I love food in general. Like, high-end food is like my love language. Take me to a nice restaurant, and I'm a happy girl.
Is there a food you don't like? Like you said, I can't stand this food. Like, don't go to me.
Food. No, not usually. I like so many foods, and I love, I mean, there's not a whole lot that I don't like. Now, bad sushi, like that kind of thing, you don't want. Like, I don't want to just eat at a regular place. Like, I want to eat at a nice place sushi, because you want it to be fresh. You want it to be by an ocean, not fishy tasting. So, yeah. I don't eat fast food.
Wow.
But that's probably my husband's fault, because he for years never ate fast food. So I was like, so I just stopped eating it.
So are you located in Texas or?
I'm in Atlanta. Wow.
Mm-hmm. See, that's different from like all the other DBZ people, because all of them I know like are based in Texas.
And that's where I started. Most of it, where I grew up, was in Texas. So we just moved to Atlanta like 3.5 years ago. So.
Wow. Big difference, or is it the same?
Oh yeah, it's very different. Well, and like, it's not as hot here, funny enough. And then it's like so many trees. Texas is not that way, but I do miss the really, really good food in Texas, the really good Mexican food in Texas. And I love the people in Texas. I miss them. So.
Nice. So yeah, see, we're based in, Chicago.
Oh, okay.
That's where we're based. That's where...
Yeah. I was just in Chicago not so long ago. Now I have to remember why, but I was there not too long ago.
Well, next time in Chicago, Les, we could take you out to a good bite to eat on, like, sushi, pizza, anything.
Yeah, no, Chicago's a great foodie town.
Got you. Oh, my God. Okay. Now that, you know, things are, you know, normal now, or getting back to normal, do you have any projects that are in the works? Anything coming up?
No, I just finished a big project, you know, like with, I said, with my album, and then the DBZ movie. And so right now, I'm just kind of in a... finishing getting that out and finishing all that before I start creating again. My husband also just is putting out a documentary the end of September, which is a lot of work and a big project. So I'm helping to kind of, you know, give him space to work on that. So we feel like we've been in a season of like releasing all the stuff. So then you've got to go back into a season of creating again. So I haven't started just creating just yet, but I'm about to go into that season.
Wow. That's pretty cool. Now, when that comes out, too, let us know so we can watch that and support your husband.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. His movie is called Super Spreader.
Super Spreader. Okay. Keep on the lookout.
Keep an eye out for it. Yeah. It's going to hit like about 500 theaters in the next. So it should be one near you, I'm assuming. So.
That's pretty neat. Awesome. Now, what advice would you give younger people to become a voice actress, a singer? What would you say is your advice?
My advice would be practice now. Don't wait. Like, if you feel like you're called to be a singer or a songwriter or a voice actor, start taking lessons now. Like, a lot of times people want to wait until they feel like, oh, there's a possibility of having a job. But to me, I always feel like if you are going for it right now and you really believe that that's what you're called to and you're practicing and you're working on, you know, you can watch a commercial and see if you can imitate that voice. You can listen to these types of music and see if you can imitate that style. Doing those kinds of things now, that way when you do have an audition or there's an opportunity, you're already ready. So for voice actors, I say, like, you got to learn how to act. You know, like, that's one of the main things, because, you know, you don't get a lot of time to character develop. You know, you don't have a lot of time to like go home and study the character. You get there, you get a script, you get a little bit of what's going on in the scene, and then you got to immediately just start to go for it. So with that, it's like you need to already be ready to, you know, start acting and getting comfortable with that. And there's just so many ways to do that. So I always say just jump in and go for it and enjoy it, because, you know, if you are enjoying the process now, then you'll enjoy it when you're doing it later. If you don't enjoy it now, then you probably won't enjoy it later either.
Or I like to add, like, to, like, stay humble. Remember you came from.
Oh, yeah. That's a big one. Yeah, for sure. because humble people are fun to work with.
Yeah. Don't I hate when people think, oh, I'm old. You mean, you know what I
mean? No, everybody's got gifts and talents. And I say that in a good doctor is just as valuable as a good accountant, a good chef. There's so many different things. We all have gifts and talents that we all get to benefit from. So just because somebody's good at voice acting doesn't make me better than somebody who is serving incredible food, or who's a great mom, or, who's really a good student at this time. We all have gifts and talents. And so it's to realize that when we all work together and we're all in our lanes, we all get blessed by it.
I like that a lot. Now, would you be willing to come back on for part two, answer some fan submitted questions somewhere down the line?
Sure. Yeah, I'm always down to do that. If I've got the time, if I'm not traveling too much, I'm open.
Perfect, because I'm sure that maybe just someone says, oh, I have a question for you. Have any questions?
For sure.
Thank you. Now, before I ask you my last question, Meredith, do you have any questions?
Ooh. Which one is your favorite character that I voice?
Ooh, all the characters you voice? Probably Android 18, I'm sorry. That's fine.
Oh, no, don't apologize. That's fun. I'm glad you like her.
That's my favorite. And then my little sister, her favorite is Mirren.
She's a great character.
And if you want to tell her, you say you really liked her drawing.
Absolutely loved her drawing. I thought it was beautiful.
Nice. And I don't know if Michael told you, my brother, I started these podcasts to help spread positivity during these tough times, the pandemic. I want to cheer people up. I want to lift people up,
I love that. That's the best thing. Doing what you can to lift other people up.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. Now, Meredith, is there anything you would like to promote and shout out? Like, I'll link down below in the video description. Anything you'd like to shout out?
Anything I'd like to shout out to promote, or just a shout out for?
Anything.
Hey, you should listen to the Bois podcast for sure. That's a highlight for sure. That's my number one shout out. But also, you can go listen to my new album. Go see the super movie, Superhero.
Like that. And if you want me to also link down your Instagram page, would you like me to?
Oh, yeah. My Instagram is going to be Meredith Malden is my handle. That's my married name. And then I have a website as well called Songlab MSC. So if you want to become a songwriter, if you want to learn more about that, then there's classes and things that I teach for stuff like that. So,
do you have a Twitter at all or no?
I actually don't have a Twitter. I don't have a Twitter and I don't have a TikTok. All I've got is Instagram and Facebook.
Simple.
Simple and easy.
Nice. Now, also, what inspired Songlab? Because I know Song Lab's a company. What inspired that?
Well, for 7 years, I worked at a church where we started really writing music. And then I just learned so much through that time. And the music for that church kind of went all over the world. And so then when I left there, I started just kind of all that I learned, I packed into a weekend to teach other worship leaders who work at churches how to write their own songs and how to kind of teach them what I learned about worship and all that through that through those little weekends. So I do kind of events where people come and learn and sing and write. And those are just super fun. So that's my first passion and what I love to do the most. I love it all. I feel like I'm really blessed to get to do a lot of different things.
Oh, that's very beautiful. Like all your work you do, Meredith.
Oh, thank you so much. I love it. It's fun.
Well, thank you and Meredith for being an awesome, amazing guest. I had a fun time chatting with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah. Have a great day, everybody, and stay awesome. And you stay awesome, Meredith.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you that I can approach your throne, calling my name to come closer, throw off my care.